Anti-Brett Kavanaugh activists berating Republicans in an attempt to stop the vote on the Supreme Court nominee. Look at this.
Mr. McConnell,
how do they feel?
Mr. McConnell, we know that we respect
the
Democratic
Please don't block
process.
The way, ma'am.
Excuse me, are you assaulting me? Excuse me, am I being assaulted right now?
Why are you putting your hands on her? She's walking.
Senator McConnell, do you always turn your back on women like this?
But despite that harassment, Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell vows the vote will go on this week.
Their goalposts keep shifting. But their goal hadn't moved an inch, not an inch. The goal's been the same all along. And so let me make it very clear. The time for endless delay and obstruction has come to a close. We'll be voting this week.
After they get the information from the FBI. So is it time to vote on Brett Kavanaugh? Here to debate, we've got spokesperson for the RNC, Kayleigh McEnany, and Fox News contributor, Jessica Tarlov. All right. I've got a feeling you don't agree on this. Jessica, after the FBI submits their investigation, yeah, where they go out and they interview all these people, mm-hmm, will it be time to vote?
I think it will be time to vote then, as long as they are permitted, obviously, by the White House to interview as many people as they see fit. It seems like President Trump is on that page from his, yeah, impromptu remarks yesterday, where he was
the White House has said, just interview anybody you want. Just be done by Friday.
Yes, right. But then you have the NBC report from yesterday that that it shows that Brett Kavanaugh actually knew about Deborah Ramirez's allegations before the New Yorker story, which contradicts his testimony from last week. Another allegation against him. Hopefully, the woman who's come forward, Kelly Burcham, I believe is her name, she said that she's reached out to the FBI twice and they haven't gotten back to her.
Right.
So we need to make sure that the FBI is covering every single, mm-hmm, lead here. But after the report comes back, absolutely, it's time for a vote.
And, you know, Kayleigh, it looks as if some of these activists who are not pro-Kavanaugh people have been very effective. You know, they were able to corner Jeff Flake. Now they've cornered Mitch McConnell out at the airport. What do you think about that particular kind of tactic?
Well, I can tell you this. There's one person who will not be intimidated, and it is Mitch McConnell. He is subject to these kind of protests, these crazy protests all the time on immigration and other issues. And as he said with the immigration protests, this is not about persuasion. This is about intimidation. This is the Democratic Party of Maxine Waters. It's a ridiculous tactic for these activists to be in an airport yelling that the Republican Party is the party of pro-rape. Give me a break. And then one of these activists was thrusting herself next to one of the agents by Mitch McConnell and then yelling that he assaulted her. These tactics don't work. And if they're so concerned with sexual assault, as they should be, as we all should be, why aren't they in Minnesota protesting Keith Ellison?
Jessica, remember, I think it was a couple of months ago, some activists or protesters got really close to Mitch McConnell. And then his wife, Elaine Chao, is the one who said, hey, get out of here,
you
guys.
She was awesome. Talk about a lady boss there. She's like, get out of my husband's way.
You can't like this kind of confrontation.
No, it's certainly not how I go about expressing my political opinion, but these people do represent us. Our tax dollars pay them. I'm very against hounding anyone out of a restaurant. I really appreciated that Beto O'Rourke stood up for Ted Cruz and said him and his wife should, mm-hmm, obviously be able to eat anywhere. But I do think with something this important that people should be able to express themselves. I think what happened with Jeff Flake, which obviously mattered a lot to him to hear from survivors of sexual assault directly how important this issue is.
They were activists.
But you're not claiming that they weren't sexually assaulted.
No,
a lot of people are. Republicans have activists as well, who I'm sure if they had the opportunity to talk to Chuck Schumer about something, would say something to him.
These protesters were both from the same group, the ones that accosted Flake and McConnell, and they were from a George Soros activist group.
Yeah.
And if you're interested
George
in changing
Soros
minds...
George Soros isn't such a dirty word to me.
True. If you're interested in changing minds, go to their offices, have a dialogue, have a conversation. Don't kneel on the sidelines at an NFL game. Don't accost someone in an elevator. Don't push someone out of a restaurant. Go have a dialogue. That's what it should be about.
Well, the kneeling, if your problem is getting in people's way and accosting them, kneeling then seems like the exact appropriate thing that you should be doing when you're protesting for criminal justice reform and racial and social justice reform in this country. But that's another week where we'll get back to the NFL.
Indeed. All right. Ladies, thank you very much. Great
chat. Thanks a lot, Steve. Congratulations on the cookbook. Cookbook's out today.
Congratulations.
Everyone cook.
There
you go. Steve tells you to.
On both sides of the aisle. Can't we all just get along?
Well, I can't actually cook. I don't know if that's a liberal thing. But
The cookbook will help you. They're easy recipes.
And great Instagram posts.
All right. Thank you very much.